Let's discuss about overall systems of an automobile, chassis and accessories generally, to give a basic idea about what exactly the systems in automobile is. So from here, this is one of the chassis and accessories of a particular vehicle. So let's start from the beginning. The basic of the automobile is consists of this. There are two long members, and in between that there will be cross members. So long member and cross members both together join the chassis. So front, this is a front underrun protection device. What it means that when an impact takes place, if the ground clearance is more, there is a chance of vehicle getting into the underneath of the vehicle and accident causing. For that, government norms is there for making protection devices. So this is not exactly a front underrun protection device, but just it's an old vehicle. So after that, here comes the radiator. You know, the function of the radiator is to cool the engine and other components. So this is a basic. This is a radiator, and from the for cooling the radiator, there is a radiator fan is provided that you can see here, and which is connected to the engine drive. Like there are so many timing gears are there. So with the help of engine, this fan will be rotating and cooling the radiator. Similarly, we can see. So this is the engine. In the engine, we can see that there is a radiator fan is mounted, and there is also other components. This is called the alternator. Alternator is also getting drive from the engine. We can see some timing gears are there, and this alternator's function is to generate electricity, and that electricity is stored into a battery. There will be a battery of 12 volt or 24 volt will be there. Currently it is not shown here, but the purpose is to, for working of the electrical equipment, we have to generate electricity. That is the alternator purpose. And we can also see this is called the side member, a long member we can say, or side member we can say. And inside there is, we can say, cross member. This is a engine cross member, we can say, because where is the engine thrust and all. And then we can see the both tires. There are two tires, and there is a front axle is there. Front axle is this thing. And okay, tire, there are, in this type of tire, this is called the rib type of tires. You can see the surface is flat, because for maneuverability, for turning and other things, more surface area will be good. That's why this type of tire is used. And usually in the rear end of the truck and all, lug type tire is used for more load capacity. Okay, let's move on. So this is a typical engine, and you can see the coolant will be going to the engine, base engine, from here, and it cools the engine. And the water is again circulated with a water pump, which is also mounted on the engine. Okay, so we discussed till the engine. So engine is over. After engine, what happens? There will be clutch is provided. This assembly is called a clutch, but inside that there is a flywheel is there. Flywheel purpose is to store energy. We know that. And I forgot to explain this one. This is called a starter motor. So for starting the vehicle, like bike and all, we can kickstart it and low energy is needed. But when we have to start a bigger automobile, we have to rotate the flywheel to get the ignition started. For that, we use a starter motor. Normally, Lucas TVS is the major company in India and all. So here is the clutch assembly, which used to engage and disengage engine with the transmission. This is called the transmission or gearbox, what we call. Inside, we can see there's a clutch shaft, counter shaft. There are gears provided for giving, like first gear, second gear, according to speed, torque, we can change it. There are clutches are provided, like dog clutch, to engage and disengage. That we will be discussing in the next video. Okay, from that clutch, then the transmission is assembled here. From the transmission goes to the propeller shaft. Propeller shaft will be giving drive to the vehicle's rear axle. For our drive propellers, there are two types of, this is a two-wheel drive, because the rear engine, rear wheel drive is getting obtained from this. Normal Jeep and all, there will be four-wheel drive. So what happens, there will be differential also, there is two drives will be going to front and rear. That is called four-wheel drive. That is for high terrain purposes. For high terrain, we need more traction. So we have to provide drive to the front axle as well as rear axle. So this is a two-wheel drive. So we can see a universal joint for getting different type of motion, because we know that there will be different type of motion obtaining according to the terrain. For that, universal joint is provided. And this propeller shaft is going, is directly going to the rear axle. This is the rear axle. Rear axle, this is the differential, what we call differential. In differential, there will be a bigger wheel, which we can call as a crown wheel. And there are smaller four wheels, that is called crown, like star pinions. So with the help of that, we will be obtaining different rotations of the vehicle. Okay. So, and another thing we can see that for a vehicle system, it is very essential that we need suspensions. So these are the suspensions, coil type of suspensions, which is very old right now. It is also the front side also same coil suspension is used. And you can see the rear axle, there will be rear wheel hubs. And the braking type of braking is used as hydraulic braking in this particular vehicle. So the fuel tank is mounted in the rear end of the vehicle. Okay, this is normally a metal type fuel tank. Capacity will be low, I think around 40 to 80 liters is the maximum capacity. And there will be, this is called a cross member, as in the rear cross member also there. And okay, this is all about the basic systems of an automobile. And thank you for watching.